Hello everyone, my name is Sudesh and my project topic is the kinematic analysis of a 5R mechanism with 2 degrees of freedom. In this project, kinematic analysis of a 5R mechanism is investigated using MATLAB. In this analysis, there are 3 types of analysis: position analysis, velocity analysis and acceleration analysis. In order to plot the graphs of position, velocity and acceleration with respect to time, a MATLAB program is developed after completing the analysis of the mechanism. In this mechanism, there will be 5 bars and 2 motors, so that we have 2 degrees of freedom. To develop a MATLAB program, we have to get a formula of the position of the desired point of the mechanism. So I have used analytical method to get the coordinates of all joints. Now if we have the coordinates of all joints, then we can simply plot the lines by matching these points. And to get a running mechanism, we can iterate this process for a desired time. Let's start with the analytical method for the calculation of the coordinates. A simple schematic of the mechanism representing the coordinate system is shown in the given figure. Link AB and link D, which are driven by motors, are two driving links. Link BC and link CD are driven by the two driving links. We assume that the link lengths are L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. The angle between links and x-axis are θ1, θ2, θ3, θ4 and 0 degree. According to the geometric relations of the mechanism as shown in the given figure, these relations can be derived. For point B, xb equal to L1 cos theta 1, yb equal to L1 sin theta 1. For point D, xd equal to L5 plus L4 cos theta 4, yd equal to L4 sin theta 4. For point C, xc equal to L1 cos theta 1 plus L2 cos theta 2 equal to L5 plus L4 cos theta 4 plus L3 cos theta 3. Yc equal to L1 sin theta 1 plus L2 sin theta 2 equal to L4 sin theta 4 plus L3 sin theta 3. From equation 1 and equation 2, it can be found that theta 1 and theta 4 are independent in the system, and theta 2 and theta 3 can be determined by theta 1 and theta 4 as follows. Theta 3 equal to 2 tan inverse a plus minus square root of a square plus b square minus c square divided by b minus c, where a equal to 2L3 L4 sin theta 4 minus 2L1 L3 sin theta 1, b equal to 2L3 L5 minus 2L1 L3 cos theta 1 plus 2L3 L4 cos theta 4, c equal to L1 square minus L2 square plus L3 square plus L4 square plus L5 square minus 2L1 L4 sin theta 1 sin theta 4 minus 2L1 L5 cos theta 1 plus 2L4 L5 cos theta 4 minus 2L1 L4 cos theta 1 cos theta 4. From equation 2 and equation 3, we can calculate theta 2 as follows. Theta 2 equal to sin inverse of L3 sin theta 3 plus L4 sin theta 4 minus L1 sin theta 1 divided by L2. So now we have calculated the coordinates of all joints A, B, C, D and E. Let's start with the MATLAB program. Firstly, we define variables for link lengths and the time. Then we define angular velocities omega 1 and omega 2. After that, we define the points A, E, B and D. Now we define theta 3, theta 2 and point C as we have calculated. The distance of point C from the origin can be calculated using distance formula. By differentiating coordinates with respect to time, we can get the velocity of point C. Hence, we can calculate x component, y component and the magnitude of the velocity of the point C. By differentiating velocity components with respect to time, we can get the acceleration of point C. Hence, we can calculate x component, y component and the magnitude of the acceleration of the point C. Let's plot the mechanism. Firstly, create small circles to show joints clearly. After that, show the bars by plotting lines between respective points. Now pause the program for some time to make the mechanism visible. After that, delete all circles and lines to update the position. Then plot position versus time, velocity versus time and acceleration versus time curves. Now we are done with the MATLAB code. When we run our script in the MATLAB application, the output will be like as shown in this video clip. Here we can see the position versus time curve, the velocity versus time curve and the acceleration versus time curve for the point C. Since the fiber linkage has 2 degrees of freedom, small deviations from the specified path are possible without significantly altering the mechanical advantage function. It is one potential application, the design of strength machines, where it is important to control force while allowing the user freedom of motion. So far, we have calculated the positions of all joints of a fiber mechanism using analytical method. The kinematic analysis of a fiber mechanism is shown by plotting different curves using MATLAB in this project.